John here, guys, and today we're talking about the Run Cam Session. No, wait, the Run Cam 5. It's not the session, but it is the same size as the session. This is Run Cam's latest action camera. Unlike Fox here, they did decide to use the exact Session 5. Measurements, so this is maybe slightly more of a clone than Fox here, but a couple of notable things about this is a lot of the design is different. It does not have a waterproof door, so this thing is not waterproof. It has like a little slidey thing. The USB micro, not USB-C, is open, so you cannot take this underwater. So if your action involves any type of water sports or diving, this is not the camera for you. But if you want an inexpensive camera that you can put onto a head mount to go biking, snowboarding, or maybe not snowboarding because the snow could mess this up, but definitely FPV flying, this is a good option. I do like that the lens cover element is slightly smaller on this. The rubber kind of goes a little bit further on the top and bottom, only exposing the center part of the lens, so less breakable glass film area. Comes with, you know, the little cable connector, blah, 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 blah. The way that you configure this is it only has one button. That button is to turn it on, hit record. It does not auto turn on and record, so you have to hit it a second time to actually make it record once it is powered on. If you double click it, that puts it into configuration mode that you can use the app in order to set your functions. Then you connect it to the camera and it downloads those settings. It's not an interface where you actually connect to the camera, which confused me a little bit. It took me a little while to try to get that app right, but once I got it, this thing does get some good footage. It's probably somewhere between the quality of a GoPro Hero Session 5 and a Session 4. So better than a 4, maybe not quite as good as a 5, but it's really, really close. And those 5s are getting rarer and rarer. It's harder and harder to buy them. There was a time where you could snag them for 100 to 125 bucks pretty easily, but now they're getting so rare that I'm mostly seeing them for 150. Sometimes people want 170 for a 5. This thing you can get for 100 bucks, easily 90 bucks on sale at most places. Banggood and a lot of the other big FPV carriers carry this thing. Links in the description below, of course. But not a lot to say about this thing. I prefer the Session 5 form factor because it can use all of the same mounts. And that is really key to us because a lot of us have custom 3D printed mounts that are different for each quad. And so if we all of a sudden go with a different form factor like the Box 2 by Fox here, we then have to get all new mounts, which, let's be honest, guys, people are gonna make mounts for GoPro. So if you wanna use an off-brand camera, it needs to be compatible with all of those same features. So it needs to be this exact same size. The 4K footage, because yes, it does do 4K, is good, totally usable. I personally like to use 1080p 30, but for this video, I went ahead and did everything in 4K. The four videos I shot with this, I shot several, but the four that I ended up using were, the longest one was maybe 6 minutes long. The shortest one was like 2 minutes. Those four videos took up 8.5 gigabytes of data. So 4K is very memory intensive, but this camera took it like a champ. The battery lasted throughout all four of those, no problem. And I will say that personally though, in the future, if I continue to use this thing, I'm gonna put it back on 1080p 30. I don't really think for YouTube anything more than that is necessary. It's just another option for FPV camera. I think it's totally usable. You decide in the footage if you think this is good enough. The gold standard for FPV is easily the Hero 7 Black with the Hyper Smooth. But notably the Hero 8 is gonna be coming out very soon. But a lot of us much prefer this form factor and we can get away with some of those sacrifices, including YouTubers like me. Now, I think if you're doing any type of commercial work, you absolutely have to go for the top of the line, the best. If you watch Mr. Steele's video where he's flying all around his house, I commented that he is exceptionally good at that sort of thing. He should be getting on set somewhere. He has a great eye, a great ear. He has to use the best. If you're just doing flight footage for archival to show your mates, to show the YouTube community, to show us, this is totally fine. You decide. I got some sunset footage, some middle day footage. What do you think in the comments? Does this look as good as a session five? I have two session fives. One of those is broken. I sent it off to try to get it fixed. It worked for like a couple weeks and then it's not working at all. So that one's done. So I have one left. If that thing goes, I don't think I'm gonna pay $160 for another one. That's just ridiculous. Session, I keep calling this the session. Run cam five. That's the answer. Thanks guys.